Many of the new researchers suggest that yelling at kids can be just as harmful as hitting them. Hi guys, my name is Bindya, and yes, today's topic on Plum Talks for Teen is why we should not yell at our kids. In one of the studies, it was revealed that yelling at children could lead to behavioral problems as well as it could lead to depression also. So let's find out how yelling at kids can impact their emotional and physical health and how to deal with it. The very first one is, it leads to aggression and behavioral problems in children. Some kids behave rebelliously due to constant yelling by the parents. After some time, this needs to be defied. Their parents turns into aggression and becomes a part of their personality because they think that this is normal to imitate their parents' aggression, hence, which becomes a part of their behavior eventually. So all the issues related to their behavior has to be handled carefully, whether it is psychological or physiological. The root cause of aggression in kids is insecurity and frustration. So it can be tackled by giving an ear to them and listen to the problems and definitely deal it with them politely and calmly. Second is, yelling changes their brain development, brings a sense of loneliness in them and maybe raise an ill-mannered kid. So a kid's brain is developing. So any negative incident changes how their brain develops. Yelling makes them scared of everything and it changes the development of the brain as well. In case you think that you want your child to be disciplined and listen to you, please create a set of rules at home. Become a role model for them by being disciplined and take a time out with your kids. Make them understand the values of being well-mannered and side effects of not being well-mannered too. Good manners should be taught to them at an early age, right? And also engage them to the activities that will make a bond between you and them. Third is sense of insecurity. Yelling at your kids will make him insecure and a sense of not being valued or heard. This will bring him constantly lie to their parents and slowly detach from their parents. This might lead to anxiety and depression in the kids, which is dangerous. When you think that the parents are not happy with something that the child has done, don't just yell at them. Parents should share their feelings with them. This will make the kid understand emotions and learn to manage them. This will also learn that anger and frustration along with the happiness is a part of human emotions and it is okay to sometimes feel them. Fourth is poor academic performance. Non-supportive environment at home could lead to kids' poor academic performance. This feel of insecurity, lack of confidence, and no concentration can lead to no interest in the academics. So what you can do, you must always encourage your child to perform his best and always boost his morale and confidence. If they don't match up to your expectation, let them know that what went wrong and how can they just overcome with this and what are the ways that you can correct those things. Fifth is development of fear. Definitely, if you think that yelling at children will not make him scared of anything and everything around it, that's a wrong perception. So verbal abuse can make the child small and undervalued and just scared of the consequences of his feelings. What you can do, make sure you listen to your child, address his problems calmly and deal with it like a friend or a mature person. Screaming and yelling will not get you the respect you want them to give you. Sixth is poor self-esteem and lack of confidence. Yelling by parents, even at the smallest of the things, makes a kid believe that they're not good enough. Repeated yelling at them results in their self-confidence going down in the long term. So what you can do to make your kid feel confident, you can boost the child's confidence simply by being an active listener. Give them the opportunity to discuss their issues with you and avoid being judgmental, even if you think that the decision that they have taken is not the right path. Some parents often talk about feelings guilty and yelling at the kid and seek ways to practice positive discipline. Some tips for parents to practice positive dealing without yelling are: take a time out. Yes, take a time out, talk to your kid about the issue and explain it to them. This will teach the kid about boundaries and managing frustration and anger. Second is talk about emotions. When the parents are not happy with something the child has done, parents should share their feelings with them. This will make the kid understand emotions and definitely learn how to manage them. Third is tell them about the consequence. parents are not so much superhuman, so it's normal if they get frustrated or angry sometimes. But they should remember that yelling is not the way to make kids discipline and do the right thing. This will help in good mental and physical development of the child, and emotionally grow up as a strong kid, become good humans, and definitely a good future parents. I have created a poll yesterday on Instagram and my Sugar Plum community, wherein I just wanted to see whether how many times in a day, I mean, parents are yelling at their kids, and results were amazing. They were yelling at around 3 times or 4 times a day, which was quite a number. And parents are not superhuman, guys. It's okay. It's okay to yell at our kids, but yes, in a way that it should not hamper the brain development of the kid, and it should not come as a roadblock between the growth and development of a kid. Hope you like my video, guys, and see you again until my next video. But please don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and share. Thank you very much for watching. Bye bye.